when you're not used to people staring at you, and it's not all the people there. It's like one of every five people, but when there's hundreds of people in a crowd, it seems like a lot of people. So, you know, you start to get self-conscious because you don't know if they're just looking at you because you're different, or if you've broken a rule, or made some cultural, you know, kind of mistake. So that's why I wasn't always comfortable with the staring. But in most instances, I got used to it. And I'm going to tell you guys a couple stories about people staring at me in Japan. Like, getting on the train. First time I got on the train and to go to school, like, everyone on that train looked at me the second I stepped on. And, you know, why wouldn't they? Even if I was Japanese, like, oh, hey, look, a new person. Because they're, like, all usuals. They all always take this train. But they just stare at you, like, okay, why is this white girl invading our train? And, you know, after a while, they finally got used to it. After about a week, they stopped looking at me as much. Another time, when I was getting off a train, I thought it was funny because these trains kind of have, like, curtains. So I get off a train and I'm walking off and all these girls like throw open the curtains and they're like pressed up against the glass and they're all watching at me, like looking at me and like waving and like trying to scream stuff at me. So I thought that was really cute. Once I was on the train and this businessman dude, I don't know, he was like 40, he gets on the train too. And in this little area of the train, it wasn't very busy. It was just me and my whole sister and this guy. So he goes and sits by us. And, like, his seat's next to ours. And he keeps looking over the edge of his seat like this. Just looking at me. So, yeah, that made me a little uncomfortable. Another time we were at school. And it was cleaning day, so all the classmates at the high school, you know, clean at the school. So everyone was sweeping and mopping and things like that. And me and my sister were, my whole sister, were outside pulling weeds. And she goes, "Johnny, look, it's your fans." And I was like, "What?" And I look up and there's this balcony thing. And there's like seven guys leaning over it just watching me. Like, just staring at me, and I look up, and they all, like, ran away. So, that was cute. I didn't really mind that. Now, this is a story all my friends make me tell them again and again. But this was probably my most uncomfortable moment in Japan. My whole sister had problems with her leg from a sports injury. So, she went to this kind of, like, sports rehab place. To, you know, get physical therapy for her leg. Well, we go into this room and there's random people getting massages and things. And a couple people in Japanese, my host sister told me, and also one in English, offered me a massage, which I thought was creepy because, I'm not hurt. As my host sister is getting her knee massaged, there's this guy, and I don't know, he's like 30-something, okay? And he's giving this old man a massage on his left leg. So he's massaging his left leg, and he's watching me, like he's not even paying attention to this guy he's massaging. He just keeps looking at me, and I found it rather funny at first. Like, I started laughing, and my host sister was like, "What's going on?" But I just kept laughing because I thought it was hilarious because I would catch him staring and he'd get all flustered and embarrassed and look away and then he'd look again 30 seconds later. But I kept moving because it was starting to freak me out a little bit. And the stool he was on wheels, so he keeps like moving around the guy he's massaging, moving around his little table so he can get a better view of me. I was just like, okay, this is weird. And this guy gets so distracted by looking at me, he ends up massaging the guy's right leg instead of his left leg, which is the one that's injured. So the guy starts screaming at him, and he's like, "Right leg, right leg." He said it in Japanese, though. And because he was massaging the right leg and not the leg that was injured. because he got distracted by looking at me, which I thought was really creepy. So I just got up and, you know, kind of moved out of his view again. And then as we were leaving, he kind of follows us out of his room and he's like looking at me walk down the hallway. I'm like, okay, this is weird. And then once I got outside, I thought I was finally safe. Well, it turns out I wasn't safe because he somehow magically appears all the way on the other side of the building by a window watching us as we get into the car. And I started laugh crying and I told them everything that happened and they're like, okay, you're never going in there with us ever again because that's just weird. That's some of the staring that I didn't like. And you know, that was just in my little town of Ise, but in Tokyo and Kyoto, they're just like, okay, foreigners. They speak English to you at the stores and things like that. They're used to it. They don't pay that much attention. So that's just a couple of stories about people in Japan. If you're a foreigner, no matter what you look like, black, white, if you're Asian, they probably won't pay that much attention. But they will look at you. They just will, because it's cool and you're interesting and you're not like them.